In this example, we are given that two identical point charges plus Q are fixed in a gravity-free space at a separation 2L and another particle with mass m and charge minus Q is placed midway between these charges. Now, this particle is slightly displaced a distance x perpendicular to the line joining the charges and release. We are required to show that this particle will execute SHM and also we need to find out its oscillation period. In this situation, say if these are the two charges plus Q which are fixed. At center, if we place a charge minus Q, we already studied in previous articles that the particle will be in a stable equilibrium. As being a negative charge particle, it is in a stable equilibrium for its displacement perpendicular to the line joining the charges. Now, if this particle is displaced by a distance x, then this minus Q will be pulled toward these two charges with a force F, and say if this angle is theta, it will be experiencing a restoring force. This restoring force we can write as 2F cos theta, and in this triangle as this length is L cos theta can also be substituted. Here twice of F is given by Coulomb's law, that is KQQ by X square plus L square, and cos theta we can write as X by root of X square plus L square. So this will be 2KQ capital Q X by X square plus L square to power 3 by 2. Now as we are given that it is slightly displaced, or we can write x is very very less than L, then we can neglect this term of x square compared to L square. Then this restoring force we can write as 2kq capital Q x divided by, if we neglect this x square, is L square to power 3 by 2, it is L cube. So acceleration of particle can be given as A is restoring force by mass, and as being acceleration opposite to displacement or restoring in nature, we can write it minus 2kq capital Q by ml cube multiplied by x. And if we put the value of k as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, this will be negative of qq by 2 pi epsilon naught ml cube into x. And we know for SHM, A is written as minus omega square x. So comparing these two equations, we can say that this particle's acceleration is also directly proportional to x. That means it is executing SHM. And comparing these two expressions, we'll get the value of omega to be root of qq by 2 pi epsilon naught ml cube. This implies time period of oscillation we can write as 2 pi by omega, which is 2 pi root of 2 pi epsilon naught ml cube by qq. That will be the answer to this problem.